In Mastercam 2025, we've added new parameters and safety zone for hole making toolpaths. We cover some of these changes in a recent What's New video, so make sure you check that out if you haven't already seen it. Safety zone is utilized in multiaxis hole making toolpaths to create a boundary around your geometry to dictate the motion of the tool during linking moves between hole features. The tool motion can either use a rapid or an alternative feed rate. Let's dive into some of these parameters and see the new controls and how they affect the linking motion. We'll look at this beam bracket that has some hole features on different planes. So here in this beam bracket, we have all 8 of the holes selected, and we can see that 4 holes are going in this direction and the other 4 holes are going in this direction. So we can green check out, make sure we grab the 16 millimeter drill, and we'll make sure our tool axis control is on 5 axis. And under linking parameters, we can go to safety zone and turn that on. So first we have to define our shape. So we'll select the beam bracket, and we have the same options as last year and previous years. We have our rectangular shape, cylindrical, spherical, and wrap. So wrap is sort of like the minimum volume, so we'll keep it on that. And the difference is all in the background. So we have a new algorithm that allows for safer motion and unlocks new tolerance values so we can really dial it in. So we can green check, and we'll turn off the feed rate override at first. So we can turn on blending and smoothing, and this opens up all of the new tolerance values. And to better visualize that, we can actually go into the View tab, and under Advanced Display, we can turn on our vectors for better visibility. And we'll leave all the values as default, and we'll just click the Apply button and see what the vectors look like. So here we can see the link motion between all the different holes, and we can start adding in values. So blending distance, let's put a value in like 1,000 millimeters. We'll hit the Apply button, and we can see immediately that these vectors are no good. They're pointing into the part and probably at the table, and it's not gonna run. And that's because this value is too big to go between this link move and this link move to calculate a vector. So let's try something smaller, like 50 millimeters. And we see that now the vectors are pointing at the normals on the shape, and it looks pretty good. But if we zoom into the corner here, we can see this group of points. Now, if you try and run that on a machine that will hit every single point, it's gonna be jerky and it will shudder and probably not run very well. That's where smoothing distance comes in. So here we can add a value like 10 millimeters to kind of spread out those points along the corner. And when it sees a linear motion here, it can, you know, just add a point here at that smoothing distance value. And then linear tolerance, this is really similar to the tolerance value, the linear tolerance value on your toolpaths, except this isn't directly affecting your surface finish, right? This is the tolerance value of your link move. So you can actually open this up, and so like 50 millimeters, and it might make the link motion more faceted, but depending on your geometry, this might be a little more beneficial and have less motion on the machine. Maximum angle step is an old value. So this is if it sees the tool moving more than this value, it creates a new vector. And then the last new enhancement is in the feed rate override. Now the feed rate option will pull from the machine def parameters. So if we add something that's out of range, it'll warn you and tell you what the limits are. So we can put it back to 12,500, which is maximum feed rate in the machine definition. So we can green check out, let this regenerate, and we'll backplot this toolpath and see the new link motion is smooth and safe. You see it wraps nicely around the part and it goes to the next hole feature. So these new safety zone features will be beneficial on some machines and controls where rapid G0 motion can run really poorly, especially with those larger angle changes. By dialing in these new tolerance values in conjunction with any smoothing settings on a control, you can really tailor the linking motion to create safe and smooth motion.